real teachers making a real difference in the lives of our children, our community, and our future. Welcome to the 2020 Collier County Golden Apple Celebration of Teachers, the 30th year of this recognition. I'm NBC2 anchor Peter Bush.
And I'm Kelly Burns. Here at NBC2, we think it's important to highlight the good things happening in our community. That's why every year we set aside this time to introduce you to the outstanding educators shaping the lives of our children.
This year, the landscape has changed because of the coronavirus pandemic affecting all of our communities. And we're seeing firsthand the important role that our schools play. As we navigate new challenges and change the way we reach our goals, we need only look to teachers as an example. They adapt every single day to best serve our students.
For the next hour, we join the Champions for Learning, the Education Foundation of Collier County, as they honor these teachers for their best practices connected to innovation, community involvement, and ideas that work.
Today is the official kickoff for the Golden Apple Teacher Recognition Process, so we are here to celebrate our teachers of distinction.
There's nothing quite as sweet as being recognized and thanked for a job well done. That's what happened for these teachers from 52 public schools in Collier County, named 2020's Teachers of Distinction. These are the educators using great ideas to ignite a passion for learning in your children. From a scrumptious breakfast at McDonald's to a more formal luncheon at Fleming's and a $250 cash award, each teacher is thoroughly thanked for their hard work in the classroom.
It's a great opportunity for our community to see the amazing things that are happening in our classrooms.
After sharing their best practices with a community-based committee through a presentation and classroom visits, the surprise comes. Six teachers learn that they are this year's Collier County Golden Apple recipients.
I didn't let myself think that, you know, we'd get to this final part. I was just excited to be recognized.
I look at them and I look at what I do every day and I go home and I reflect and I'm like, should they learn it? How can I do it better?
I really appreciate it being here at Immokalee High School. Anything that I can do to showcase the students here and how amazing they are, that's all.
I've wanted to be a teacher since I was in the fourth grade, and it was because of teachers that inspired me that really helped me to become the teacher that I am today.
I am in shock. I am so happy. I mean, I truly love what I do. I'm going to break out crying now. Just very excited. Really, I love what I do, and you know, my students, it's all them.
Yeah, I'm just overwhelmed. It's really cool. This is awesome, so I appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Sable Palm Elementary third graders are learning to think about their thinking. Wait until you see how teacher Eileen Fuentes is helping them become learners who are developing their reasoning skills and balancing that with their emotions. In Eileen Fuentes' third grade class, her best practice of metacognition plus social emotional learning equals confident, balanced scholars. By completely engaging students academically and emotionally, she's helping them create a deep understanding of their own feelings and awareness of their learning.
So I'm going to read the text out loud. I am going to think out loud. I'm going to use my what? My metacognition, and I am going to be thinking of things that go on in my brain, right? But I'm going to be saying them too. When I stop at certain points, you are going to jot down three words. Can it be more than three words? Absolutely. But we're going to jot down a few words that are going to remind us or represent what we understood from that particular paragraph. Last paragraph, it says immensely. So let's make a hand signal for immense. Go. So what's immense? Huge, big.
So my best practice is called metacognition plus social emotional learning equals confident, balanced scholars. And so what it is let's start with metacognition. Metacognition teaches students to think about their thinking or think about their thinking process or as themselves as learners. So the way it works is you actively have to explain what metacognition is to students and you have to model it. You could be, and it applies to every subject area. You can have a reading passage and you would say to students, okay, so I'm actively going to think and I'm going to think out loud and you're gonna hear what I say as the wheels turn. And SEL or social emotional learning is really all those needs that children have that need to be met in order to achieve the rigor, in order to achieve problem solving skills, in order to achieve greatness.
I enjoy this class because she doesn't just teach us with just boring words and just normal words. She teaches us with more words that you can absorb and more juicier words that you can memorize for the rest of your life.
My son was fortunate enough to have Mrs. Fuentes as a teacher for second and third grade. Mrs. Fuentes' social emotional learning practice is ideal for my son to flourish and shine.
By helping her students think about how they will achieve their learning goals and modeling what should be going on in the brain to problem solve and persevere, she's engaging authentic student-driven learning while creating great academic success.
She is an amazing teacher. We've known her for probably about 5 years now since my daughter was in the second grade. She goes out of her way in every single aspect of education. We have nothing but good things to say about her.
I'm very proud of her and all of her students. It was a team effort.
I teach them about the things that they can control and the things that they can't control and how to handle those things. And we actively talk about that. We have morning circles where we sit down and we say, we take different components of behavior, so respect, self-control, integrity, perseverance, and we talk about what that looks like in a person.
By embedding META and SEL practices throughout the lessons and classroom interactions, she's created a deep sense of discovery and responsibility for her students, making them strive to be lifelong learners.
My mom has always taught me the importance of an education and always taught me that if you work hard and you study, you can go anywhere. She's my hero, you know, she just
made me want to not just be that way for my own children, but for so many others that I can touch.
Teachers are some of the greatest unsung heroes, but at Suncoast Credit Union, we're trying to change that. Taking the time to hear about these influential leaders through the Golden Apple Awards give all of us the opportunity to honor the work being done on behalf of our children here in Collier County. Supporting education is part of our DNA at Suncoast Credit Union. Founded in 1934 by local educators, we have a long and treasured history of supporting and affirming teachers. Since 1990, our Suncoast Foundation has raised and donated over $25 million to programs and organizations that promote the education, health, and emotional well-being of children in the communities we serve. Our partnership with Champions for Learning ensures that teachers are valued and supported. As the presenting sponsor of the Golden Apple Awards, Suncoast Credit Union congratulates all of the nominees, the winners, and those who wake up and teach every single day. We could not be more proud to have this short time to share your stories of triumphs in the great profession of teaching.
Your fantastic future. Suncoast Credit Union can help you get there with trusted advice and the banking you need to live your best life. Because we're a credit union, profits come back to you with lower loan rates, higher earnings, and more free services. Anyone who lives on Florida's West Coast can bank with Suncoast. We have convenient branches, mobile and online banking, and free access to more than 30,000 ATMs nationwide. Your fantastic future starts here. See what banking at Suncoast can do for you.
The ability to understand the why in history and see connections to today is an important skill. Immokalee High School teacher David Stalen is helping his students develop it.
High, there's an 11th grade history class that's combining empathy and pragmatism to create better understanding. David Stalen's best practice of engagement in rigor and empathy to promote learning is helping students understand the why and apply it to history and their lives today.
Right? What we're focusing on this week and last week is a lot of the 1960s and how it comes to impact us today. Remember, our goal in a lot of these activities is to get us to not just look at those programs, those laws, the people that are acting and all this, but understand that they're real people. And the key here is that each and every one of the programs that we're going to talk about today has a direct impact on many of our daily lives. Okay, so that's the relevant part, right? That's the idea. We want to be able to see that things are happening because we're able to put ourselves into their perspective and see how that action impacts us today.
The title of my best practice is Rigor and Empathy Promotes Learning. And so it's a twofold kind of process there, where the empathy really is content related. Because this is a history class, I think empathy is really, really easy to incorporate into it, but all the more important to incorporate it into the content area. Because we're talking about real people, everyday people, interacting, just a lot of them are at different times, but to understand where those people came from, I think is that starting point. The second part of that is the rigor factor. And a lot of times when we talk about empathy, we, in a classroom, believe that that means that we sort of stifle or it's at the cost of that rigor of, you know, being highly engaging, demanding much of our students, and essentially putting that learning into their hands and making them create the understanding.
I like his class because he makes us be more engaged in what we're doing rather than just learning from the board or reading from a book. We actually like get into it
We make posters, you know, take notes, and he is really detailed about everything that he teaches us.
What is great about Mr. Stallings' class is that the kids feel like they're part of something bigger. They come in and they're engaged right away. He helps them with the state exam as soon as they walk in, but he makes it immersive.
By having students delve into why people acted a certain way, who it impacted, what they accomplished, and why it was important at that time, David's encouraging collaboration and deeper understanding of history and how it applies to critical thinking, both in the past and present.
So for a 17-year-old to be excited to go to her history class, to me that says everything. So it's a class that she enjoys going to just about every day. And she'll come home and she'll tell me, hey, you know, I learned in Stalen's class today, X, Y, Z, and she's just excited about history. He brings it to life for her. It has helped her relate to the past and has helped her to connect it to things that are happening today. And as a result, I see just a little bit more empathy in how she relates to other people that may or may not be similar to her or may not be in similar circumstances to her.
All of his kids will say the same thing, that he's a very good person and that he's a very good teacher, that he opens our minds to everything, and that he just makes sure that we have, not only that we have good test grades, but also that we have a good experience in his classroom.
If they come back and say, hey, you know, when you told me to not give up, or, you know, try a little bit harder, or, you know, put some effort into things, and then they come back and say, that really stuck. Or for some of my other students that have said, the class was a lot harder than the college class I'm taking right now. I'm gonna take that as a badge of honor a little bit, because if it's too tough here, if it's more difficult here, then I've done part of what I'm supposed to do, which is train you for after this, what comes next.
By focusing on rigor and empathy, students understand the content and other people's perspectives. These relationship skills impact their social and emotional learning, and that is vital to their own well-being and future success.
As a teacher, there are many times where, you know, it takes months to see, and sometimes it'll take years to see that payback, an award like this. It helps to just confirm that you're making an impact, you're making a positive impact with the students that you're working with at the time.
At Conditioned Air, we believe that a solid education is the key to a responsible and productive society for Collier's future. Conditioned Air is delighted to support the Golden Apple through Champions for Learning, and we've been doing so for more than 20 years now. On behalf of over 350 Conditioned Air co-workers, I'd like to congratulate the outstanding Golden Apple recipients this year. Your passion for teaching and sharing knowledge to children and young adults is inspiring to all of us. Congratulations.
52 teachers and their best practices were put forth by their schools as Teachers of Distinction this year.
Join us as we honor their contribution to the classroom.
Golden Apple gives our community a chance to say thank you to our teachers and gives them the support and tools they need to provide students with the best possible education. Through visits to classrooms and meeting teachers, I have learned how creative our teachers are in getting students excited about their own learning. I am inspired by their dedication and commitment, and it is my honor to provide teachers in the Golden Apple process with cash awards. Collier County students and families are the winners thanks to these outstanding teachers.
Fifth grade is that magical time toward the end of elementary school and right before middle. And teacher Sarah Bratcher is making the most of it. Through the use of content-focused songs and public speaking skills, she is empowering her students. At Lake Park Elementary, Sarah Bratcher's fifth grade English language arts classes are singing along to learn through song, with her best practice of raising leaders through songs and public speaking. By using songs and acronyms, she's getting the material stuck in their heads, creating a positive mindset while enhancing learning.
It's a new day in our classroom. Smile so bright, we're coming at you. Yeah, we're dreaming and achieving, embracing the daily ride. We are leaders working together. Take some risks, let's be bold, do it for one another. We got each other, we are students of the future. Future in room 104, we are so fresh. Super focus and respect. Maintain eye contact, stand to speak. And don't forget your hands to complete.
Let me hear it.
Future! We are the future! We are the future! 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 We are the future! We are the future!
So I use songs and chants in my classroom, whether it be to teach content or motivate my students, celebrate successes, morning songs, whatever it might be. The second part of my practice that I use is I have my students stand to speak. We have an acronym in our classroom called FRESH, super focus, respect, maintain eye contact, stand to speak, and don't forget your hands to complete. I use that in my classroom because I really want to teach my students how to be leaders. It's such a pivotal year before they go to middle school, and I think it's a lifelong skill that they'll use no matter what profession they pick later in life. And I really started using it in my classroom because I struggled as a student growing up with retaining information.
She is just one of the best teachers I've ever had. I really think that her learning style just keeps me engaged, and I want to go to her class every day. It's not like I don't want to. I really do want to go to her class. And she really speaks to my heart. And not only does she inspire me as a student, but also as like a person.
I think that Mrs. Bratcher's best practices of raising leaders through singing is super creative and clever and fun. It's really enthusiastic. It brings the kids together every morning through their morning song, and then they have a mistake song that my son actually walks around the house singing. I think it's great for every kid. It kind of doesn't really matter what sort of student you are, what your personality is. The whole class gets together. To sing and do these rap battles.
By using the FRESH acronym approach that teaches focus, respect, eye contact, standing to speak, and using hands while speaking, she's building strong leaders and lifelong learners, all while cultivating a positive mindset that encourages continued development.
They are with our children basically more than we are, and they are forming these little ones to become leaders of our country, to be strong and proud. And we really need to thank them and recognize them more often because they do so much in the classroom for all of our children.
I think it's important that we thank our teachers because they're a big part in our life, and well, especially Ms. Bratcher. They do a lot of things for us, like she treats us as like her own kids.
The world needs more of who these individuals are. I think that a lot of times my students try to fit the mold and fit what other people want them to be. And I want them to know that they can be exactly who they were made to be. I think it's impacting them and future generations to have confidence in themselves and know that we fall down, but through those failures, we grow and learn from them.
Sarah's best practice is engaging her students while building them up and having fun. Her creative academic songs grab their attention, enhance their learning, and create amazing results that will stick with her students for years to come.
I became a teacher because I felt called to be a teacher. From the earliest of memories, I just felt God calling me to be a teacher, but it's more than I could have ever dreamed.
Morris Park is proud of its long-standing sponsorship of Champions for Learning. As a nonprofit and Naples' premier senior living life plan community for the past 40 years, we recognize the importance of supporting those organizations that strengthen the great quality of life here in Collier County. With 3 campuses and over 800 employees, Morris Park understands the critical nature of equipping and preparing students for future learning success. Congratulations, Champions, for valuing and supporting teachers and principals and impacting learning for every child. We're very proud to partner with you.
This year's Teachers of Distinction showcase some of the best teaching practices in all of Collier County Public Schools.
Join us as we celebrate their accomplishments.
Hi, I'm Penny Fisher, editor of the Naples Daily News. All of us at the Naples Daily News would like to congratulate this year's Golden Apple honorees. Without the dedication you provide your students and schools each day, this community would not thrive the way it does. Thank you for providing our young generation the environment that allows them to flourish into young adults who will become active and devoted members of their communities. The Naples Daily News is proud to sponsor such an outstanding program and organization.
Student-centered learning is key in Elizabeth Garcia's eighth grade class at Manatee Middle School. That strategy is teaching her students a valuable lesson about responsibility and respect. At Manatee Middle, Elizabeth Garcia's best practice of a student-centered classroom has created a community for her eighth grade language arts and global perspective students. Shifting the focus of instruction from the teacher to the students creates an environment where they are learning from experience and taking ownership of their learning.
Okay, so we still have one more essay to write, okay? And before we look at the structure and so forth, I wanna give you guys a heads up of what your prompt is gonna be. So if you can turn to the prompts real quick, the last page of the packet, okay? And in addition to informative writing, we've also been working on the Holocaust, right? So the essay that you are going to work on, okay, that you're gonna respond to is the following, okay? Look at it with me, make sure everybody's on that last page, okay? So in collection 5, you read about the experiences that Anne Frank and others had during the time they spent hiding in the secret annex and hiding from the Nazis in a small attic. What was it like to live in their secret annex? And you're gonna be writing an expository essay about the living conditions in the annex, okay? Looking at that, who can tell me what the purpose of it is? Daniel, you can just look on it with Alexa for now, okay? James Lee.
To write an expository text.
Yep, so go ahead and underline that if you haven't done so already. You're gonna be writing an expository text, or essay, I'm sorry. That's the purpose.
My best practice is a student-centered classroom where the students learn by doing. So it takes the focus off me, the teacher, and it focuses on them where they are doing the learning, and we do that, you know, in a variety of ways. So with musical essays, it gives students a chance to really analyze the different elements of that essay. So when the music plays, they have to, you know, just like musical chairs, they'll rotate clockwise, and then when the music stops, they'll sit down. And for example, I'll say, okay, now identify the evidence for the essay. And they have to, you know, highlight the evidence in a certain color and make sure that their classmate has that evidence in there. If they didn't have it, they could give some feedback saying, hey, you know, where is your essay or what would go in this paragraph? And then when they're done doing that, the music starts again and then they get a chance to do a different task.
The reason why I enjoy this class is because every day I look forward to this classroom. I feel that Ms. Garcia helps us very much in all of our stuff, especially in writing, because that's a skill that not many have. And especially like when you go to college, there's where you have this opportunity where you have to write papers and all that stuff.
I think it's amazing how they get tools to be owner in charge of their own learning process. He wants to learn in every subject. He's very determined to continue reading and learning by himself.
By creating opportunities for students to take learning into their own hands, it provides structure with increasing responsibility, builds communication, encourages collaboration, and builds trust, creating strong peer relationships.
My daughter loves, as soon as she walks into that door, she's in heaven. Yeah, she always talks about her. She learns so much. So many different things. She gets home, she talks about what she learned, so many different topics. I think it's very, very important to recognize and appreciate teachers. Teaching it, I'm sure it's a really, really hard job to do, and not a lot of people see that.
I feel like our teachers should be recognized because they try to set the highest bar for us and go as far as they can to help us as students become the best that we can be.
I feel like my best practice is changing the future for my students because it's you know, creating independent learners, which that's a skill that they need when they go to high school, if they plan to go to college, teaching them to also respect each other's opinions.
By using different learner-centered instructional methods, Elizabeth is helping students learn by doing, deepening their understanding and increasing their success.
What inspires me is really my students. And, you know, obviously it's important to, you know, teach them certain standards, certain things that we're learning in language arts. But most importantly, you know, just being able to make a difference in their lives and, you know, help shape them as humans and as people. That's really, you know, what I love about being a teacher.
It's important for NBC2 and Waterman Broadcasting to donate time to support tonight's Golden Apple Awards. We're so proud to honor these teachers for what they do each and every day to inspire our young students who will become society's next generation of leaders. I hope as you watch tonight's special that you'll go back into the classroom and remember that one teacher that really inspired you and that made you the success that you are today. And then you'll understand why it's so important that these wonderful teachers be honored.
It's incredible to see how the teenagers in Serena Hampton Dunn's class at Gulf Coast High School are digging deep into history and learning how to effectively communicate what they learn. Watch how her teaching techniques are helping students transition into adulthood.
In Serena Hampton Dunn's 10th grade world history class at Gulf Coast High, she's creating student success through small group settings with her best practice, conversations in the pod. By arranging desks in a pod formation, she's encouraging students to dive deeper into conversations, providing her with the opportunity to assess their understanding of the material along the way.
So if we were doing a DBQ and LEQ, you would have a prompt. And in this one, it's a very simple one. It says, develop an argument that evaluates the causes of African and Asian imperialism in the 1750 to 1900 time period. Okay, now, what are we missing out of the thesis? If it's asking for a cause, what else do we need to do? An effect, which would give us a what on the exam, the complexity point, okay? So, when you do your thesis tomorrow, in my class, okay, because you guys will be writing, okay, this is under assignments, okay, so you'll do this, you'll type this out, all right? You must give me an effect, okay? You're gonna have about 40 effects today, okay? So you have plenty to pick from.
Okay, so my best practice is what's called conversations in the pods. Basically, what I am trying to address is, one, for them to have a conversation with each other. I feel that, you know, for AP students, they really, can do the work by themselves, and that's it. But for me, I feel like, you know, them having that conversation, it builds them to write, because not always do kids have to write to get their point across. I feel that if they are conversing with each other, then they're able to, from one student to the other student, they're able to bounce off ideas from each other, and then something that maybe another child didn't know or is like, oh, that's a great idea. And then, you know, then when they go to write, then they're able to see how well they structure their writing in a different way than when they first started off with me.
I enjoy this class because it opens up learning from beyond simply learning and looking at content to collaborating and dissecting it carefully. In this class, I feel like we take it one step further, look into the content more thoroughly, bounce each other's ideas off of one another, and really examine everything.
This class is a great class for my son and the other students because it expands their thinking outside of contemporary times. I think her best practice is amazing. It allows the students to get together and literally lift the words from the pages.
By having students analyze the same questions and documents together, they're able to corroborate and contextualize the information through collaboration, improving their comprehension of the lesson.
Alexia has definitely learned a lot from this class. She's both been able to keep up with the
the gruel, of the intensity of the program. She's been able to probably increase her rate of reading, her comprehension. She does well now with kind of being able to express her opinion in a group setting amongst her peers. And I think that's good. It gives her some life skills.
I'm really happy that Coach Stone was selected for the Golden Apple just because she put so much work into us and really wants us to succeed.
So majority, if not all of them, will go to college. And I remember being in college and I would have those study groups and, you know, we'd sit in a room and then it was like, okay, who's gonna start? They can dive right in without having to feel that awkwardness, you know, and then they'll be able to ask those questions, you know, those high order questions that we've been doing here. They've also practiced that. So they'll be able to pull in other students to be able to have those conversations as well.
By fostering student-led conversations centering around learning, Serena has improved her students' critical thinking and increased their knowledge with significant results.
Whew, the goals were set very high for me from when I was wee young to all the way into college. All I knew was excellence. I grew up, you know, you have to do everything with 110%. There was no 100%. And so I think that carries over into my teaching. And even when the bell rings at the end of the day, I'm not done.
Stock Development is proud to have supported Champions for Learning for close to 20 years. The amazing programs they provide to our educators, students, and support staff is instrumental to the success of our community and our company. As a company, we believe quality matters. Quality in education is vital to the health of our community. We currently employ over 365 employees who have families and children who attend schools in Collier County. It is important for them and all of our residents to have a quality education. At Stock Development, it is our pleasure to support Champions for Learning and all that they do.
There's a leader within all of us, and the fifth graders at Teresa Golden's class at Veterans Memorial Elementary School know that firsthand. In Teresa Golden's fifth grade class at Veterans Memorial Elementary, her best practice is using student leadership to empower learning for her students in reading, writing, and social studies by encouraging them to embrace the leader within and utilizing the 7 habits of highly effective people. They're setting their own learning goals and reflecting on everything they're mastering along the way.
So, ladies and gentlemen, you're going to go ahead and you're going to take out your reading goal sheet, okay? And while you're reviewing, you're gonna think to yourself in your head, what did you do last night to work towards your goal? Because our objective is to always make sure that we're becoming better readers. Here's my question first. Who is in charge of you and your choices? Can you point to the person in charge of you? Nice. I like that each one of you pointed to yourself. Because you're in charge of your choices. The most important thing you can ever learn in life is that you are in charge of the choices you make. So you need to spend a few moments reflecting on what choices did you make last night to be successful, okay? Did you read your 10 pages? Did you do some iReady? And then did you use a different strategy to help make yourself a stronger reader? Because you're a leader in your reading, right? Are you in charge of your own learning and your leading? Absolutely. My best practice is using student leadership to empower their learning. My belief is that children should realize, especially as they're making that transition out of elementary school into the secondary school, the importance of that they're in charge of themselves as a student and as a learner, and that their choices have power and each choice has an equal impact on them. And so if they understand that they are a leader in their learning through their choices, and they set goals with attainable strategies and things they can do each and every day that they can then accomplish
small things that will lead them to, as they get older, being able to accomplish the bigger things, to the really challenging moments when something is most challenging, and then they're able to fall back on what they learned about choices and goals and strategies to truly come through and accomplish.
The reason why I enjoy this class is we do a lot of fun and unique projects, and our teachers just makes learning overall just much more fun. My favorite project was with the chickens, because we got to play with them and we got to hold them, and we learned the entire process of how the chicken is born and how it grows inside the egg.
This is a great class for Evan, because if you look around the classroom, you'll see everywhere that it's all about individuality, yet coming together as a group, being accountable, and positivity. And that type of environment really creates a safe space for learning, but it also boosts confidence.
By having her students actively in charge and leading their own learning, they've become fully engaged in the process, resulting in increased academic success.
I think it's important to recognize and thank everybody that does a great job, especially our teachers. They are a great social and emotional piece on the growing up of the child. I think they should all be recognized and thanked every minute, and we are just very thankful for our Collier County Public School teachers.
It's important to thank our teachers because they help us accomplish our dreams, and they help us grow up and learn and help us do new things and try new things.
What inspires me every day is helping kids understand that they're in charge of their story. They have power over what happens to them. And you might hit some bumps in the road, you might trip a little bit, but it doesn't matter. You're just gonna get up, you're gonna dust your knees back off, and you're gonna keep going because you're in charge of your story. And you can change your story at any time.
Teresa's best practice has unleashed the potential for growth and motivation in her students, creating smiling faces and the best learning gain she's ever experienced, with all of the benefits going to her students.
Most people probably think that teachers have always enjoyed school and it's always been really easy. My story is a little different. So I was actually held back in second grade because I couldn't read. And so now I'm a teacher and I teach reading and I have my master's degree in reading. And I love all things reading and writing.
Tonight, we honor every teacher in every school going above and beyond to help shape our children's lives.
The teachers of distinction in Collier County are a great example of that, and we thank them for their dedication.
Good evening. My name is Dan Lampe, Market Manager for Southwest Florida with Wells Fargo Advisors. And on behalf of Wells Fargo, we'd like to recognize the teachers who have been selected tonight as Golden Apple recipients. We recognize the important role all teachers play in the lives of students and our communities. In 2019, Wells Fargo invested $455 million in national organizations as we embarked on a journey to create greater community impacts. Here at home in Florida, we gave nearly $14 million to more than 1,000 nonprofits, schools, and community organizations. Thank you to all our teachers for everything you do each day to help our students succeed. And again, congratulations to our winners on the 30th anniversary of Champions for Learning.
Thank you for joining us to help celebrate these fantastic teachers from Collier County.
And thanks to all of our Collier County honorees and the hundreds of other teachers making every day special for your child. You leave us all in awe of what you do. I'm Kelly Burns.
And I'm Peter Bush. Good night.